book, right? Just losing your time on the sofa or outside in the sunshine with a really good read. For the month of April, we're tackling a wide range of subjects, everything from mental illness to an amazing novel about a group of South Asian teenagers and their quest to find identity here in the United States. Joining me now to discuss is our friend and award-winning podcast host, Zibby Owens. Good morning, darling.
Good morning, Michaela. How are you?
Oh, I just love getting to chat with you about books. And there's been so many. I mean, man, the pandemic had people writing.
And reading, by the way.
And reading, right.
Reading more than ever.
Right. Absolutely. I want to actually show you one that I was tipped off to. It particularly tweaked my interest, you know, obviously, as a journalist. This is a really terrific book that's coming out soon, and it's called 20 Women Storytellers, spotlighting women and who are these incredible storytellers in various different ways. Journalists like Clarissa Ward from CNN or New York Times, Dion Searcy, a combat photographer, Heidi Levin, a filmmaker who did an RBG documentary, Betsy West and Julie Cohen, and director Jessica Yu. I think any budding journalist, especially any budding female journalist, that's a book that would be a great gift for them, or you could pick it up yourself. It's a great read.
Totally agree. Actually, I read that Dion pretended she was homeless for a while and didn't shower for a week to try to put herself in that role.
Can you imagine? Can you imagine? It's just terrific when you get to see the lengths that folks will go to get those stories and how important storytelling is. So speaking of stories, let's dig into the first one. When the Stars Go Dark.
Yes, this is by Paula McLean, who many may know better for her first book called The Paris Wife, which was better in a certain
way. Yeah,
which was so good. So it turns out Paula was actually in foster care herself and wrote this amazing article recently in the Modern Love column for the New York Times about her experience of sexual abuse in foster care, which was horrific and awful. Anyway, she channeled all of that feeling and thoughts on abandonment and everything into her latest book, which is called When the Stars Go Dark, and it's based in California, and it is a gorgeous thriller, kind of a new genre for Paula, and it's just unputdownable and so good and poignant, especially knowing her backstory.
Okay, you just made me decide that I'm picking that up today. Okay, the next one is from somebody who's known as a YA author, but she's making her debut with adult fiction, Donna Freitas.
Yes, no longer just a YA author. Donna Freitas' new book, The Nine Lives of Rose Napolitano, is perfect for anyone who, like me, tends to debate things. Should I do this? Should I do that? I don't know. Are you like that, Michaela?
I can be.
Yes, I can be. So this is like nine different outcomes for the same thing.
Should she
have a kid? Should she adopt a kid? Should she do this? Should she do that? And so
kinda
each
sliding
life...
doors.
It's like Sliding Doors, which is like my favorite movie. So it's like nine different alternatives of how she can live her life, which is so interesting.
Yeah. I am fascinated by this next one. I think I can relate to this. This is a book about essentially, you know, this author's effort to try and find a better way to describe the phase of life that she's in, instead of just calling it midlife, because she felt that middle age sounded too, I don't know, ominous.
Did I Say This Out Loud by Kristen von Augtrop might be one of my favorite books lately. It made me laugh out loud so many times, which for me, that's like such an A+ part of a book. Her stories about how she accidentally swallowed part of a plastic fork, probably in a salad, and then had to go to the emergency room. Yes, it's true. So funny. And her dad going around and being like, oh, should I put a plastic fork on your pillow? Anyway,
funny.
And also poignant about being more of an empty nester now and how the house is now quiet as she writes on her porch. But the essays are fantastic and very snackable,
says. I like that. And if her name sounds familiar, she was the former editor-in-chief of Real Simple magazine, wasn't she?
She was.
I love that.
And she writes about that in the book, actually.
Oh, that's great. If you're a fan of that magazine, that's a great, like, sort of tie-in. Okay, the next one is Donnie Walton, a new book by Donnie Walton.
Yes, and this was so well written that I didn't even realize that the fictitious narrator was not a real person, because in the beginning, Sunny says that she's going to go on this search for the backstory of this and accompany everybody on a tour for this singing group. Anyway, it's amazing. It came with little tickets, which I thought were so cute, and it's a fantastic, really, really great read about what happens with Opal and Nev as they go on this musical journey across the country and all of the associations conversations with that. It's really, really great and told from many points of view with all these interviews, and it's going to be an amazing audiobook.
It's going to be, that's a good one for a road trip. Pop that in. And especially when you say that you almost couldn't believe that the characters weren't real. That's a very good selling feature. All right, next up, the title of this makes me think it's Everything is Not Fine. The title is called Everything is Fine. And this is the one that is delving into the sibling's examination of his brother's mental illness.
Oh my gosh, Michaela, this book, I told my husband about it and he was like, how can you go to sleep after you read this? But the author of the book, Vince Granata, had triplet siblings, and one of the triplets ended up developing schizophrenia. Wow. As an 18, 19 year old, and ends up killing their mom in their childhood home.
Oh,
this is a true story. In Orange, Connecticut, affluent family, the mother and father were doctors. It's heartbreaking. He goes back then and tries to figure out what happened. When could he have saved the brother? The court case that follows. And I couldn't put it down.
My goodness. Talk about that. You know, I saw a line, salvaging his love for his brother. The challenge of loving a sibling who is going through, the descent into mental illness. I think that's going to resonate with a lot of people. All right. Next book is from a New York Times bestselling author.
I love Chris Bajalian. I feel like I was just talking about The Red Lotus. Turns out these amazing books, like, faster than I can read them. But The Hour of the Witch is now about a woman back in the Salem witch trials era who people think may in fact be a witch. But is she? So you have to find out what's going on in her head, why the women around her. It sort of relates to today. Moms sort of being cast out of different friend groups,
yes.
Women being rude to other women and
yes.
All of that. So there's an element of that in this book as well. And it's brilliantly written. Chris talks about his feelings of dread that he includes in every one of his books. And this one does not disappoint.
How is it that he is able to crank out so many great novels like that? It's incredible.
I don't know. He is a genius. He's like a genius. Seriously.
And then last but not least, I'm really excited to hear about this one. This is a terrific young writer who has written a book called Gold Diggers.
Yes, Sanjana Sathian. She is a great writer, and I love that this includes so many details from the 1990s, like trips to TCBY and other things that just like take you back to another era. And it's all about this group of South Asian teenagers and how they try to fit in, how they find their identity, how they bond together, and how they tear each other apart, and all of this stuff. And it's about friendship, coming of age, identity, and all those juicy ingredients that make up a beautiful narrative. And she had a huge feature in the New York Times this weekend.
Good for her.
Oh,
that'll point a lot of people to the books. The quest for identity, and especially for an immigrant coming to the United States, a child of immigrants, and suddenly you find yourself in a new nation, trying to get along as a teenager when it's already rife with challenges. That really, I think, is going to be great. Gold Diggers by Sanjana Sathian. You've given us a terrific... I'm going to have to get like 8 books, which I'm okay with.
Go get them. These are great ones.
And look, the great thing is, and I'm sure you're the same way, I love lending my books to my friends because it's a shared experience, right? I'm not pressure. I want them back, but I just think it's a nice thing to be able to share. That's why I like doing this with you, Zibby.
Oh, you too, Michaela. I love sharing them too. And I lent my books to one friend. She left them in a hotel room on vacation.
Oh,
and I was like, what? That was like my original copy. Yes, I know. I'm going to try to forgive her. But, you know,
how is the health of that friendship?
Yeah, we've overcome it. It was a challenge.
Okay, let me point you to Zibby's book, because she has one as well, called Moms Don't Have Time To, a quarantine anthology available everywhere books are sold. And, of course, you can follow her terrific podcast, which I just think is the whole, it's just such a great vibe. Zibby, you're terrific. We'll see you next month with another list of books. Sound good?
That sounds great.
Okay.
It's Moms Don't Have Time To Read Books is the podcast.
There you go.
Thank you.